I was genuinely surprised when making this video. Today's video was originally going to be about making a shulker filler that could fill up a shulker from empty to this layout here. And so the big thing that I needed was something that could fill a empty shulker dynamically. So I did research. I scrolled through YouTube and I found nothing. Shulker fillers rather are more designed to fill up something like this, where you have one type of item or a set of items where you really don't care how many are in there, but I want something that looks like this. Now, I don't necessarily care about the order of items, but the quantity. So I needed something better. I reached out to my viewers and one of them made this. This was a shulker filler design from CrazySmile that would use this loop here and these two control points to allow the flow of a total of 64 items that pass through this hopper here, each time triggering this dropper, which would go into your shulker box or maybe a set of hoppers. I still needed something better. So I kept on experimenting using a copper bulb to automatically do toggling and continue with the loop system that he had made. I even tried doing things with hopper clocks and still kept on going and going and coming to. Then I started using pulse extenders and seeing if maybe multiple pulses would work, but still nothing satisfying. Eventually, I even ironically reverse engineered his design completely and was trying to set up the auto trigger, but I wasn't satisfied. I needed something better. And that's when I thought about the fact that this is being made for the Redstone factory, where we need the crafter. So that means anything that's gonna be in 121 is on the table. And I got to thinking, what happens when you take a pot and you have a dispenser dump into it? That's when I realized that when you have a dropper and a full jar and you trigger it, nothing happens. And this is what triggered me to finally come and design this system here. Now, a big thing I was targeting at this point as well was stackability. So this guy was designed with stacking in mind. And you have right here a auto dropper system that goes into a jar. Once the jar fills up, it triggers this copper bulb, which locks the auto dropping system and unlocks a hopper beneath the jar, allowing for exactly one stack of items to end up in this chest. Problem was, I still didn't like this design, so let's clean it up just a little bit. And you get this design right here. It's relatively efficient with your blocks and stuff. Really, the only thing that needs to change is this item becomes a slab, and then you have a very clean design that is stackable. And a link to this and the other designs shown today, big designs shown today, will be available on a GitHub link found in the description below. But I think what you guys really want is y'all want to know how to build this structure. So right here are the materials that you guys will need. I would suggest going ahead and taking a screenshot here so that you can make sure to look at them if you are not using the litmatica file provided. If you are building this, I suggest you start by building up relatively close to the level you want this to be, and then place your pot. And I suggest this because this is the center of your design. Once your pot is placed, you're going to want to take whatever direction you want the output to go. You will want to place one temporary block and then place your hopper right behind it. Once that hopper is placed, you're free to go ahead and destroy the pillar upward and that temporary block. Behind the hopper, on the level just below the hopper, you will want to place a top slab and a solid block of some kind, and you'll place two redstone dust. Next, we're going to build the auto dispenser. Place a temporary block and your dropper here, and then you'll want to make a 2x3 set of slabs. Next, you want to take a comparator and have that come out of the dropper, follow that by a solid block, a dust, and then beside the dust, another solid block, another comparator, and one last piece of dust. Take the comparator that is reading from your dropper, set to subtract mode. Now you can destroy your temporary block, and we're going to take a target block and put it beside the dropper. And that is your auto dispenser set up. Next, we're going to set up the flip mechanism to take it from loading mode to unloading mode, which should happen every time you cycle this. You'll place one slab with a comparator that's flowing into a copper bowl. Beside that comparator as well, you'll place another comparator that is reading from a redstone block or some full redstone power source. Outside of that copper bulb, you want to place two solid blocks. These do need to be solid, one comparator and one dust. Next, you'll place a redstone torch so that it looks like just like this. Next, you'll place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slabs towards the redstone dispenser. You should line up with the redstone dust most closest to your dropper. Finally, you'll place one last slab connecting those two together, and you'll want to take and place a repeater going straight into this dropper system. This will lock the dropper so that it's not dispensing while you're trying to unload your stack. And just go ahead and place a redstone line right here. It will flash a couple times if you're building like this. All you want to do is shift right click the redstone dust on the bottom layer with a saw block. And you'll want to also place a slab. This is going to be used to build the next layer if you're building multiple in a tower. Now, so this is the final build. Make sure, of course, that everything is working properly. For example, if the redstone system was flashing a little bit earlier, like it did in the video, make sure that this redstone torch is powered on. Otherwise, you will get some experience some bugs. But let's show you guys how exactly this works by just putting in a stack of redstone blocks, and these will begin firing into this pot. Now, I can't show you guys the contents of the pot, but you will see it's not getting into this hopper. And if we were to be reading from this repeater and it wasn't powered here, you'll be noticing this steadily climbing. In just a moment, this copper bulb will turn on. And there we go. Once this copper bulb is on, the system is actually locked till you trigger this copper bulb again, making this a fully on-demand system. For example, we can fill this dropper right here completely up. You'll notice that this pot is still emptying items out. Once you're ready to get more items, you can, of course, trigger this copper bulb, and that will unlock the system. It'll empty out a second stack. But this goes beyond just supplying one stack at a time. Right here is kind of the pinnacle and target of what the goal of this is. You'll see these boxes. I have this just for the sake of using litmatica, but this is a 9-stack dispensing system. Why 9? Because one row of items is 9. And that allows us to fill one row of a shulker. You take 3 of those, bedaggle them together a little bit, and you get a somewhat unoptimized shulker filler that I'm still in the process of working out completely how it works, namely just the actual filling portion. But this is how I'm going to be building the shulker filler for the redstone factory. If you like the idea, let me know down with a like button and comment. What would you use a stack dispenser for in your future redstone builds? But without further ado, this is Negative Light signing out. And God bless y'all. Have a wonderful day.